And there was a goddamn telephone pole. And at the top of the telephone pole was a mine. If the boat hit the pole, the mine would fall into your boat and kill everybody in the boat.
We were way out. I saw one of ours 6x6. I saw it just pulled in the air. It just blew up. And when it happened, it hit a landmine and blew up. And then I realized then, I said, we don't destroy our equipment like this. This is the real thing.
Quienes sobreviven al desembarco deben hallar un modo de cruzar cientos de metros de la playa bajo el fuego de artillería alemana para obtener algún refugio.
Machine gun fire and small arm fire mortars. This did not stop.
There are no safe places on Omaha Beach. There are relatively safe places. The seawall, a slanted wall that leads from the beach to the main road, is one. The other is the shingle, the ridge of rocks that runs along the beach, running parallel to the beach.
Todo está en juego. Si la invasión fracasa, pasarán meses para que los aliados puedan lanzar otro asalto.
And those 88 guns them Germans had was some bad guns. It was bad, I'm not kidding you.
I was about, I guess, about the second wave of our company to go in. The first wave went in, and we lost a sergeant on the first wave we went in.
The last thing I heard, he was in the foxhole. You know, he raised up and he called him, cut his head off. That's all I can say, you know.
Soldiers, I still don't see how they got on that beach, you know, safely.
Los hombres del 320 Batallón de Globos Bombarderos son una unidad de afroamericanos entrenados en Tennessee e Inglaterra.
When the enemy attacks, your balloons must be in the air. It may be necessary to inflate them during a storm or at night, and probably during a bombardment too. It's going to be your job as a member of a crew to inflate those balloons, fly them, and keep them flying.
My name is William Garfield Abney. What inspired